Okay, so let me focus this. So I rolled the bandit, the 76 bandit outside, and I got this 74 up on the left. I'm gonna take the rear end out, the gas tank, see if it matches, because my gas tank is rusted. I don't know if you can see it down in there. It's right behind that gray bucket. And this guy had some kind of traction. I don't know who made this. And also these sway links, these rear sway bar links. Let me see if it's focused. On mine, they're bent. I'll take these, I'll use these. This transmission. I'm gonna drop this while it's up in the air. I think I'll take these brake lines out of here. Because I cut through when I cut my floor pan. And just whatever I need, I'm only gonna lift this off the ground once. But this, underneath this car looks pretty good. You can see where you put these, I don't even know what they're called, but I guess they're to stiffen the body. Let's see, what they're doing is this bar is hooking the front, again, I can't remember the name of this, we'll call it the front end frame. The unibody to the, no, it's not a unibody. A unibody is the body. And then it hooks to the back frame. It's like a stiffener. But he actually welded it on, which doesn't matter because I don't want it. Anyway, whatever I can take, I'm taking. I'm gonna keep the old rear end off my car because it's numbers matching and date code. I don't know what this is. I'll look it up later. But this has got the rear disc brakes, which I want, and a higher gear ratio. Well, I did look this up. That rear end is like a 240. This is like a 325. Anyway, it's got some parts. That's why I bought it. I got my friend Jason here again. I forgot to say his name last time. He knows what he's doing.
Never.
He says never. And this has got a cooler on it. I'm not sure where this cooler goes. Let's see this hose. This is not an air-conditioned car, but I'm not sure what that is.
Transmission cooler.
It doesn't hook up to the transmission.
That is AC condenser. Pipes are cut.
Doesn't matter. So that's it for now. Okay, just getting focus. I don't know why it's not focusing. Focus. Okay, it turns out this transmission is a B5 that I pulled out of this car. I think that's a Turbo 400. So now we're getting ready to pull the rear end out. I already showed you these traction bars. Here's how they put them together. Get that piece right there. Not sure exactly what that does. And I don't know if I said this, but this has got link rods that the sway bar link rods mounted vent. And these bushings, I don't know if I said that. I can't find but it sells them. They're rubber bushing, they're split on the backside where my finger is. Anyway, get the transmission out. Oh, and then I got these X pipes out of here. Oh, debating. I mean, they're huge. They're like three inch. I just cut them right there, right in front of the axle. That's the best place to weld. There's the other pieces. Okay, I got these laid out on the table. I just want to remember. Here's the link arm. I'm gonna put all these nuts and washers and bags. This is how it goes. This is that traction bar. These are polyurethane bushings in here. Except for here, that's rubber, I think. I'm not gonna use these traction bars, at least not now. So you can see there's a little bend in this one. On mine, on that car, they're real bent. I'll compare them. This one's got a little bend in it. Now I forgot what the other one looked like. That one's got a bend to the right. They're both the same. So these are good. And like I said, I could not find this bushing anywhere. So that's good. Now I have some. Here's the journeyman mechanic. Okay, so we got this car back in, the donor car back where it was. Took out the axle. Actually, we took out the fuel tank because mine is, well, not actually, but also we took out the fuel tank because mine is rusted. In fact, there's holes in it on the side. But it turns out that this fuel tank in this car is different. I think it's smaller. Was this one the one that was smaller? Do you remember?
The one in the original was smaller.
One of the fuel tanks was smaller. So now we got this car back up on the lift. The one that I'm going to switch rear ends with. And here's some of the parts. I was saying earlier, this is later on in the day, this is probably 4 hours later. This link here is pretty straight. This one you can see is really bent. So that's it. And then the emergency, since I'm switching to disc brakes, the emergency cable is going to be different. And this side over here is, if you can see that, it's been busted anyway. And then all I had, this was the extent of the emergency brake system, which is hanging like that. So tomorrow we're gonna
Wednesday.
I'm gonna pull all the lines out. I hope we're in focus here, and so I can clean back in there. And we're gonna take these leaf springs out because I got new ones coming. Turning around. And I guess that's it. I'm just seeing if there's anything else I want to remember. No, that's it. Okay, this is the way we get the axle out. I got this roll around table. Need help?
No.
Yeah, you do. Want me to pull? I got the table.
Yeah. All right, it's off.
Okay, it's out. And the drum fell off. Oh, I got the old one.
I'm only bleeding again.
I mean, the one out of the...
This one
we're going to use with the disc, and here's the other one. This one looks beefier.
It does, doesn't it?
This is about... Here, measure. Put your finger right here. And I go over there. See the difference? This is a much beefier rear end.
This one's upside down.
No, it's upside down. This is one hand.
Here we go.
Same.
GM15. Okay, they are different. That's the difference right there. You can't see like you can on this one.
Anyway, that's how we take axles out. That's how we took the transmission out too. With this table.
If there were a motor?
Because the motor was already out. We just lowered the car down, put some blocks on the table under the transmission pan, and slid out the transmission. And it's, I don't know what I did with the transmission. It's right here. Anyway, that's it.